In our previous videos, we learned how to create full-height page layouts and complex CSS grid structures resembling admin dashboards. We also explored the difference between the autofill and autofit keywords and how to use them to create responsive grids without using any media queries. Let's continue our journey by diving into how to align grid items, as well as the grid itself. But first, hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell if you haven't already to stay updated on upcoming tutorials. This is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. Let's quickly walk through the setup we are working with today. The HTML is straightforward. We have a parent element acting as the grid container with some grid items inside it. The CSS file includes some foundational styles for the page. The grid CSS class is styled as a grid container with a setup of 4 columns of 100 pixels each. Instead of defining a fixed number of rows, this time we are using grid auto rows. This property specifies the size of any auto-generated grid row tracks, so in this case, each row will be 100 pixels tall. Then, we also have some CSS rules to define the look and feel of the individual grid items. Now, suppose our grid container is bigger than the space required to fit all the grid items. Let's add a border and set a minimum height for the parent element to illustrate this. If we look at the demo, we can see that the grid container has plenty of blank space. This can happen when the total size of the grid is smaller than the parent container. Like in this case, the rows and columns are sized with non-flexible units, such as pixels, so they don't expand to fill the available space. In such cases, we can adjust the alignment of the grid within the container. Let's first inspect the code to clarify some key terms. It's clear that the parent is a grid container, and its child elements are the grid items. But what is the total size of the grid? The total size of the grid is the space occupied by all the grid items. If we take a closer look, the last row ends in the middle of the container, leaving nearly half of the space below it. Similarly, there's some empty space on the right side. In this case, we can use grid alignment properties to align an entire grid within the grid container. The first property we will look at is justify content. It defines how the browser distributes available space between or around the grid columns. Note that it applies to grid columns, not individual grid items. If the grid container is larger than the grid itself, the justify content property can be used to align the grid along the inline axis. As we know, the CSS grid is a two-dimensional layout consisting of rows and columns. Therefore, in any grid, we have two axes: the inline or row axis and the block or column axis. In a regular left-to-right writing mode, the inline axis refers to the horizontal direction, while the block axis refers to the vertical direction. However, in a vertical writing mode, these directions are reversed. If you are not familiar with these terms, I recommend watching this detailed video on logical properties to see how writing modes affect the inline and block axes. By setting the justify content property to center, we can align the grid tracks at the center of the grid container. The start value aligns the grid along the start edge, while end aligns it along the end edge of the container. The space between distributes the free space evenly between each grid track, without leaving any space at the far ends. Meanwhile, space around distributes the free space evenly, but assigns half-size spaces to both ends of the grid. And the space evenly value also distributes free space in the same manner, but including both ends. Since we are using fixed width columns, the grid can overflow on smaller screens as we saw in our previous video on autofill versus autofit. To fix this issue, we can modify the repeat function so the grid columns can wrap when needed. The justify content property will still work as before, but the spacing between tracks may vary depending on the configuration of the repeat function. Similar to justify content, we can use the align content property to align grid tracks along the block axis. As I mentioned earlier, the block axis refers to the vertical axis, so align content will vertically align the grid tracks within the grid container. In simple words, align content behaves similarly to justify content, but on the vertical axis. The center value aligns the grid tracks in the middle of the grid container. Start value flushes the grid against the start edge, and end flushes the grid against the end edge of the container. The space between, space around, and space evenly also distribute free space, just like we saw earlier, but this time on the block axis. We also have a shorthand property called placeContent, which allows us to set both the inline and block axes in a single declaration. It accepts up to two values. The first value sets alignContent, and the second value sets justifyContent. If the second value is omitted, the first value applies to both properties. And that's how we can align grid tracks inside a grid container. Now let's move on to grid items. Just like grid tracks, grid items can also be aligned on both the inline and block axes inside a grid cell. For this, we use two properties, justify items and align items. The justify items property aligns grid items along the inline axis within a grid cell or cells. Let's inspect the code again to understand a few more terms. Like we saw earlier, the parent element is the grid container. Then, there are rows and columns, also known as grid tracks, specifically row grid tracks and column grid tracks. Each grid track contains one or more grid cells. A grid cell is the space between two adjacent rows and two adjacent column grid lines. It's the smallest unit of the grid. Then we have the grid item, which is the direct child of the grid container. Sometimes we get confused between grid cell and grid item. A grid cell is a single unit of the grid container, while a grid item is the actual content that can span one or more grid cells. When we use justify item center, the grid items will be center aligned along the inline axis of their designated grid cells. Notice that the grid cells are still occupying the same area, but the content inside now takes up only the space it needs. Previously, the content was stretching to cover the entire cell. Similarly, the start and end values align the grid items to the start and end edges of their respective cells. The stretch value, which is the default, causes the items to fill the entire cell. Next is the align items, which aligns grid items along the block axis of their grid cells. It works with the same values as justify items: center, start, end, and stretch. And then there's also a shorthand property that allows us to set both axes with a single CSS rule. The place items property accepts up to two values. The first value sets align items, and the second value sets justify items. If the second value is omitted, the first value is applied to both properties. So far, we have worked with all the grid items simultaneously. However, CSS also gives us the flexibility to target a specific grid item. The justify self and align self properties can be used to align a specific item without affecting any other content. Like in this example, the third grid item is center aligned on the inline axis and bottom aligned on the block axis. As you might have guessed, it also has its shorthand version. The place self property sets justify self and align self in a single declaration. To wrap things up, the justify content controls the position of grid tracks along the inline axis of the grid container, while align content controls the position of grid tracks along the block axis of the grid container. On the other hand, the justify items property aligns grid items along the inline axis, and align items aligns grid items along the block axis of their grid cells. Both sets have their own shorthand versions, the place content and the place items. When we talk about content properties like justify content and align content, we are referring to the entire grid and its placement within the grid container. But when we talk about item properties like justify items and align items, we're dealing with the alignment of individual grid items within their designated cells. I hope this has cleared up any confusion you might encounter while working with CSS grid layouts. Understanding how to align both grid tracks and grid items effectively will enhance your layout skills and make your designs more polished. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with fellow developers, and subscribe for more. Feel free to leave your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.